Dating and disability is at the centre of a new SBS series called Latecomers.
Led by and starring people with cerebral palsy, it's bold, hilarious and at times heart-wrenching.
So let me just hit pause on my cerebral palsy, why don't I?
That'd be great.
My God, he's cute.
Too old for you and too hot for me.
Yeah. Well, you start down your girlfriend. Hey.
I'm only here because my carer's trying to have sex with your carer.
Trying? Man,
she'll wear him down.
Frank is going to ask Sarah on a date.
Good on him.
Keep an eye on Sarah for me, would ya?
I don't want to have sex with you. Oh, wow.
Stars Hannah Divini and Mariama Smith join us now. It's such a pleasure to have you guys here.
Thank you for having us.
And this is great. Hannah, you've become a leading voice as a disability and women's rights advocate as well.
Yes.
Just how important is a series like Latecomers?
Well, I never saw anyone like me on television growing up, and we still haven't really seen anyone who looks like me on television. The fact that I get to be one of the first people to do that is so surreal to me because I spent a lifetime searching for representation and it turns out all I needed to do was look at the face in the mirror.
So, yeah. How great is that?
Well said.
It's so surreal and so strange, and I've been pinching myself this whole time, but this was one of the best experiences of my life and I'm so excited for people to see it.
Oh. So how did it come about, Hannah?
Completely by accident. So basically what happened was I got a message from one of our incredible producers. Shout out to Liam, because I know he'll be watching. And it was basically just they'd seen me on Instagram and they wanted me to come and read so that I could sort of give the writers a chance to hear the words they'd spent months staring at on laptop screens in, like, someone's real voice. There was no guarantee, obviously, or expectation that I'd get the part. And then at the end of it, the director, Madeline Gottlieb, who is incredible, came up to me and was like, so, you're auditioning for the part? And I was like, come again? She's like,
wow.
I'm expecting an audition tape. And I was like, that's great. Just, like, one question. How do you film an audition tape? I have no idea what I'm doing. And then throughout the whole audition process, I thought for sure that, like, someone else was going to get it. And then, like, a couple months later, I got the offer via email. And then I met this lovely lady and so many of our other incredible castmates.
Wow.
And the whole thing's just been a wild ride.
Oh, fantastic. And now we're meeting you guys. Now, Mariama, why don't you tell us a bit about your character, Brandy, because she's quite complex as well.
Yeah, she is in a way, but she's very simple as well. I mean, she just wants to be loved and seen and heard like all of us. And while she's been through a lot of, you know, she's a divorcee, she's a mum, she's all of these things, but at the end of the day, she's still this young woman inside that wants to be seen and heard. And that's, I think, a big theme for the whole show is to be seen.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was a big key thing that I think both our directors really pushed for, is everyone just wants to be seen and heard, no matter
so
who
true.
We are, no matter where we're from, no matter what our heritage or our landscape is, we just want to be seen and heard and connected to each other. And I think the thing about Randy is she's all care but no responsibility. It's crazy that she's a carer, but it's like, yeah, she is that, but she's so many more things. And I think the beautiful thing about these two characters is we bring out a friendship in each other.
Yeah.
Like, that's the thing. We don't need anything from each other. And that's what's so beautiful about the irony is that I'm supposed to be the carer and she's supposed to be the person I care for, but actually we don't need anything from each other. And that's what frees us in this relationship.
And I think we're kind of both doing the same thing for each other at different times in the show.
Yeah, totally.
Hannah, can I ask you about that date scene we just watched? when you read the script for that, was there a little part of you that went, yep, nope, not going to get vomited on?
Yep. And then you should have seen how they made it. And I was sitting there going, oh, Great. Okay. And what you didn't see there is there was someone literally standing behind the camera when we were filming it, like throwing it at my face.
The glamour of acting. Yes. You wanted the show news, you got it.
Yeah, totally. Absolutely, I did.
I've changed my mind. I don't want to be in it. Now, Hannah, we've talked about you on this show many times because you're goodness. So amazing. No, always positive. And again, you famously called out Lizzo and Beyonce for being ableist, certainly in the music, which led to them re-recording them.
Yeah,
so important as well. Of course it is. Yeah. So what is that like to get a result like that?
Definitely unexpected because, as you can see, like, that was just a tweet. I've tweeted thousands of times. That took me less than 5 minutes to type out, and I never expected a response like that. Mm. When it started becoming more obvious that the world was hearing me, then I was like, oh, God, what do I do if they respond? Like, how am I supposed to do that? But I couldn't have asked for better responses from both of them. They really gave everyone a masterclass in how to be an ally.
Mm. Just brilliant. We're
absolutely.
You've always been great. You've come on the show and talked to us about it every time you've done something like that. And we just sit in awe of all of your achievements.
Thank you.
So now that you're an actor as well, is that you're going to do more of it? Is that something you want to pursue?
I hope so. That's the plan. I would love to do more.
Miriama, would you love to work with Hannah again? It sounds like you two had a fantastic experience.
I would love to see Hannah keep working because she's got so much to offer and I'm just so proud. Like, to walk away, and last night we had the premiere and we watched it all and I wasn't expecting to see all six of the episodes and we saw all of it.
Yeah.
And I was just an audience member and I was so invested and so proud. And I just, I couldn't be more prouder of you, Hannah. And she's just... Well, you do have so much to offer as a young woman. But, part of me as an actor, there's a cynicism when I've been doing it for 30-plus years and she's just fresh into it and I go...
Yeah.
Like, I remember, I think I contacted you a couple of weeks later to say, how actually are you? Because there is always a come-down phase.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
There's always a come-down. And she was like, I'm coming down. And I was like, yeah. And I've got you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you've been good for each other, I can tell.
Yeah.
And do you know what? Even if you never do one again, there's going to be kids at home now who look and kind of go, well, now I can do it.
Totally.
And you're a leading force on that. It's so fantastic.
That's the whole point of everything I do, Tristan, is to make it so that the kids of the future don't have to look as hard as I did.
Yeah. Oh,
bless.
You're fantastic.
Well, you can catch Latecomers this Saturday, that's International Day of People with Disability, at 8:30 p.m. on SBS Viceland and SBS On Demand. Hannah and Miriam, thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you for having us.
Incredible to see you. Thank you.
You're fantastic.